Hi everyone, welcome to Google Developers Live. My name's Ali Afshar. Today I'm going to be talking to you about the new Google sign-in button along with Google Drive. Now, I'm really excited about this. So this week we launched a way for users to sign in to your application, authorize their data with your application that comes in the form of a button, okay, and has a number of awesome features. Mostly it's a well-trusted and good thing to have on your site. It's branded to Google, and when users see it, they know that what they're getting, the way they're logging in, that's official and that's good. Okay, so it was primarily launched for Google+. It provides some features of knowing the user's profile, and it also provides a really cool feature of allowing you to initiate an over-the-air install of your application on a mobile device when the user is logged into the web. So all those features are cool. I'm just going to show you quickly today how to get it running for your Google Drive API application. So the process we're going to do, well, the Plus team produced a set of really great quick starts. So they're just quick start applications which you can clone the code from GitHub, and you can get the code in your language and start it. So today we're going to be using Python. We're going to be using Python and JavaScript. Obviously, there are JavaScript components to this. So I'm just going to go to their page, developers.google.com/plus/quickstart-python. And I'm going to see how we're going to do this. So the first thing it tells me is that I need to install some requirements to get this running. This uses the Flask web application framework, which is something I've hacked on a lot. It's like probably my favorite web application framework. It's very simple to get started. And from a Google point of view, if you use something like App Engine, you can easily host it there. This is just very nice because I can run stuff from the command line. So as with any online live demos, everything could go wrong. If that happens, that will be really exciting and fun, so I'm looking forward to it. So let's have a look. So here we've got a shell. Let's just clear it and have a look. What I've done is I've cloned the repository. Okay, so I haven't done it in exactly the order they've said. I'm a geek. I don't like to follow directions. That's fine. So I've cloned this repository, and I've done a couple of the steps at the start where I've put in my own client ID and client secret. I've set my authorized JavaScript origins, and I've set them up to work already for this. Otherwise, we'll be going through a few forms worth of clicking stuff. And if you've ever done that before, you know how to do it. It's very simple. So this takes you through that. And let's have a look what's in our repository. Well, we've got a client secrets.json file that contains information about your client ID, your client secret, any redirect URIs, any origins. All of that is configured in the client secrets.json. You can download that directly from the API console if you like, if you don't want to create yours. But one is provided with the quick start, and you just need to modify your information. Then we've got a script, signin.py. Okay, that runs the entire web app. And then we have some templates and inside templates. There's a single template that is the index. Okay, so that's a bit of a mish of HTML and JavaScript, but really good for getting you up and running. I expect when your application is working and or you have a prototype built, you would actually extract the bits into separate JavaScript files just to be a bit neater. But it's perfect for now for what we're doing. Right, so well, let's just run it at the moment. For now, all it does is it makes calls against the Plus API. We're going to extend it slightly to make calls against the Drive API, but you see it's exactly the same thing. So right. Firstly, let's install a virtual environment. You should really do this if you're testing stuff out. I don't want to install Flask for the whole system. That would be bad. So we've called it VE, and we're going to run pip, the installer, from inside there to make sure that it's installed in the right place. Install Flask. Okay. So this goes off to PyPy, and it will install Flask for you. Really ignore the warnings. Okay, there's lots of them, but just ignore them. Then we also want to install the Google API Python client. So we can install that as well. And now these are installed in my virtual environment, and I'm actually ready to run the quick start. So VE bin Python. I'm running Python from inside the virtual env. This ensures that it has the right environment, the right Python path for the libraries. So VE bin Python, signin.py. Okay, and you see that starts, it started on all ports, on all hosts on port 4567. Okay, so let's have a look at that. And there we go. So I don't know if you can see that. There's a beautiful sign-in button there. I really like the red button, but that's actually for dark themes. So we have a kind of a light theme on this blank page. So we'll first thing we'll do is we'll start to tweak it slightly. Okay, so let's look at the source code where this button is defined. Well, we know it's going to be in the HTML somewhere, not in the head. In the body, and there we can see it. Okay, so how do you do it? Well, you just put this chunk of HTML in your page. It's remarkably simple. You have to make sure you've loaded the library, and the library will go through and convert this stuff. So let's have a look. Well, one first thing we notice here is the data scope. Now, I've been a bit cheeky, and I went through and I edited this. So this is saying, when you sign in, please, in addition to asking for the scope for the profile, ask for the drive file scope. So applications will be authorized to use and access files in the user's drive. Okay, so that's the first thing. Okay, secondly, we'll look at the access type. This is offline access. So this may be ringing like we have scopes, we have an access type. This is OAuth 2, essentially, but with a nice front end to start using it. Okay, and configurable. So we see the theme is there, dark. So let's set it to light, and let's refresh this page. And there we go. So we have a nice white button. Actually, you know what? Even on this white page, I think I prefer the dark one. So there are many, many parameters for this, and it's really configurable how you like. I like the Google branding. I think that looks really nice. So we're just going to leave that on our page, and there it is. So let's start it. Let's run it. Let's see what happens. So the first thing I see is I get this pop-up button. Okay, Google Drive sign-in app. That's what I've described this app as in the API Developer Console. And you can see this beautiful. It's really nice. In addition to the regular OAuth 2 descriptions, where we have here view and manage files and documents in your Google Drive. That's what you would show if you used regular OAuth. We have these extra two parts. And these two parts, the first one is allowing your user information and your circle information to be accessed by the application. So the application doesn't know what your circles are named or anything like this. They just know the list of people in that profile. And I can edit that list. And you can see that I've used this button before. And I'm quite tight on privacy. I don't like anyone to know anything about me. I certainly don't want this application to know who's in my circles. That's fine. So I've unselected these. And this is really nice. This is actually sticky. And it remembers what I did last time. So I have no circles selected. Okay. The other part is allowing people in the circles to see that I use this application. Again, I don't really want people to know. So I've put only me. Okay. So this will get my profile information, but nothing else really. Now, I'm very privacy conscious myself. I told you I hate giving my information out to people. But, and as my friend Vic Friesel says, I don't know of an application that isn't made better, that cannot be improved by knowing something about the user. Okay, that is just, I think, inherent. So a quality application will know about the user, it will be tailored to them, it will be socially applicable to them. So I think that's a really useful thing. Let's press accept and see what happens. So we accept, and a number of things happen. OK, so I get this page. It's showing what happened on the authorization. And it's showing a bit of information about my profile. As I say, the app, whatever your app is, will be better if it knows about the user. So how does this work? Well, I've got the Python quick start. And this is something we call the hybrid flow for the sign-in. I've managed to authorize on the client in the browser and also send a code over to the server to exchange for a token. So I've now got offline access on the server, and I've got online access in the browser. So that's really cool. I've authorized in both places. Now, I like to make my API calls from Python, from the server. That's absolutely fine. I'm going to do that. This loads the plus library, makes a JavaScript call to fetch this profile information. And then, and let's have a look at the code. and then goes through and calls, eventually, after loading the stuff, a function called connect server. Okay? And here it is. So what does connect server do? Well, it's got the token. It will send me the token, the code that I can exchange for a token. That's here. So it's going to do a post. And in the body of the post, it's got the code. And at the same time, it's going to pass some state that actually that's built into the quick start. Really good. So the quick start is using state to make sure that the person who's making the request is actually the person who initiated it in the first place. So that's really good to prevent all kinds of forgery and stealing this. So it just sends that to the connect endpoint on the server. Okay, so switching back over to the web application, we can see, and this is beautiful, this is why Flask is so nice, we have this route that is on connect and it accepts posts. Okay, so at some point in this function, we're going to go through and we're going to make an auth flow. Okay, and how's it going to do that? It's going to create an auth flow in Python and it's going to exchange the code. Okay, just like you would do if you had initiated the flow yourself by redirecting someone somewhere. So it's basic OAuth, uses the same libraries, but it does the first half for you. So that's really great. So we've got the code. This will store in a session. Okay, and eventually, this will get round to calling the people endpoint. Okay, the people endpoint is just a dummy there to show you how to make an API call from the server. So the people endpoint gets called, and it adds some information to the page when it responds with that. Okay, so let's have a look at the people endpoint. It's a lot shorter and a lot simpler. So we're fetching the session for the credentials from the session. That's where you stored them from the connect server point. And then as we go down, this should be familiar to you if you've ever used the Python client library before. It builds a service, it makes a request, and it gets the result of that, okay, and pumps it back into the page as a bit of JSON. Okay, so that's perfect. So this looks like a good place where we're going to start writing our code. Okay, so firstly, let's build a drive service. Drive equals build. So the name of the API, which is drive, the version of the API, v2 is the latest. excuse me, the latest. And we pass our authorized HTTP instance in there. Then what should we do? Well, a simple call, just a get. Let's get the about feed. Okay. So I'm going to import the pretty printer. So you can see what happens. So about equals drive.about.get.execute. Okay. And we'll print that to the screen. Okay, so that's every time this thing connects, then it should, every time it asks for the people, then it should do this. Okay, so let's try that out. What do you reckon? So we're still signed in. The app's really nice. It recognizes that you're signed in. It doesn't offer you the button again. And if we look on the output, you see our about feed. Now, the about feed is something that happens for all users in Google Drive. There's metadata about the user itself, what roles they have, what kind of files they can format, what formats they can export or import their files from, their quota, other information about their applications, their permission ID, this kind of thing that is useful for your application. So there we go. We've just made an API call. So let's disconnect and let's show you. So small bit of HTML to do this, calls Google's flow, sends the code to the server exchanges the code for a token and saves the token in the session, then the front end makes an AJAX call to the server and we see our output again. Okay, so getting the about feed, that's not that useful. What if you want to do something else, like, I guess, make a file? So file equals, oh, let's not call it file because that's a Python built-in. drive.files.insert, and let's see, body equals title. Hello, GDL. There we go. drive.files.execute, and show. that. So let's do that again. And this time it should be making a file. Let's have a look there. That's that. And there we go. There's the file that it's created. It should have the right title. But that's the metadata output. Now, in the real world, what would you do? Well, you'd pump this back to the front end and you'd display it in a nice way or whatever you wanted to do with it. Or whatever your application does do with Google Drive, the 101 use cases there. So let's have a look in the Google Drive. Here's my drive. Let's refresh that. And there we go. There's our file, empty. Doesn't have anything in there but hello GDL. Okay, so what have we done here today? We've shown how you can use the sign-in button for your Google Drive API application. Okay, whether it be on the client, because this authorizes into the client, or whether it's on the server, which your application might be one or the other. What we haven't talked about is on the mobile device, on Android and iOS. This is also covered there, and maybe soon we'll have a GDL showing you how to do that as well. So, key points to take away. Google Plus sign-in button isn't just for Google Plus. It's for all Google APIs that use OAuth 2, and that includes the Drive API. Okay, that's the first one. Second one, it's really easy to use. Grab the quick start for your language. You will be able to get started literally in 10 minutes. I cut a few steps, so it was even shorter than that. So yeah, really good. Please use it. We recommend that it's the best way to do it. It's a nice branded button, and we recommend you do that with your application. Okay? So thanks very much for joining me today. It's been really great. And if you have any questions, please follow up on Stack Overflow. Thanks very much. Bye-bye.